What's going on YouTube? It's Bobby, that Geek Dad. And today I'm going to just be doing a little quick unboxing of something I didn't think I was going to do because I thought I was going to wait for the iPhone X, whatever you want to call it. But being a dad, loving to take pictures of my family, friends, and my little one, I couldn't pass up what everybody was talking about with the camera. So I'm going to be doing a review later of this, mainly focused on the camera, maybe a little battery life. But the thing that enticed me the most was 4K at 60. And the reason why that enticed me the most is when my kid is going to be older, maybe say in their 30s, 4K at 60 is probably going to be about the equivalent of like 480p for us right now. So I want to try to get, as many videos as I can, like in 4K at 60 frames per second. I like 60 frames per second. And up until now, it's only been 1080p at 60 frames per second, which is also why I'm excited for the new GoPro 6 that's going to be coming out. But so I digress. What I have here is the 7 Plus. It's the gold looking blush-ish, goldish in the 64 gigabyte model. So why don't we? That sound always gets me. All right, throw that aside. And ooh, the box is already coming apart. And thud. All right, designed by Apple's. All your books and stuff right there. And there's the phone. All nice, new, shiny with the plastic still on it. Lift that up. Same basic stuff we've had for years. Wall wart, 5 watt. I really hate these things now. Wish they would give us the 12 watt. There's your dongle for the dongle life, your 1 meter cord, lightning cable, your ear pods with lightning on them. So nothing's really changed. Box has changed though. If this is the first time you've ever seen it, it's not white, at least this one. It's kind of pinkish, goldish, especially the inside. The inside you could definitely tell a lot more than the outside. So, all right. Let's just set that aside. And here it is. Put that glass back. And no kidding when they said, hold on. That's satisfying. I love that. No kidding when they said it was heavier, a lot of people. Same basics. This is a, SIM card, sleep wake, camera up there, ambient sensor speaker. You know, all your usual, the volume mute, volume buttons, lightning, speakers, glass back. That is heavier though. And the raised camera. Now the camera is supposed to be the same, but I guess it's because it's the A11 Bionic chip that's in here is making images and video a lot better, but it is a wide angle and a telephoto lens, a 2x telephoto lens in here. And one thing I have to say real quick, people have been making fun of the fact that Apple said we have the A11 Bionic chip. Everybody's like, ha 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 ha, especially pro reviewers. If you didn't make fun of Snapdragon or Qualcomm with their Snapdragon chip or Samsung with their Exynos processor, but you made fun of Apple for just naming their chip Bionic, you might be a little bit of a biased reviewer. Just saying. And it's already a fingerprint magnet. So we'll power this on. If it has any battery, oh, there it is, there it goes. Now while that's powering on, just real quick, one of the things I wanna do is show you that this is a case I had. It's a clear case that I had for the iPhone 7 Plus, and it's supposed to be the same size. So what we're going to do, oh, booted up already, is throw this in real quick. And yeah, see, fits. Same dimensions, same type of barely lip on this. Same thing when I used to have the iPhone 7 Plus. So if you have a 7 Plus and you are upgrading, which I kind of don't understand why you would, but maybe you're like me and you want 4K at 60, then you can use your old cases. Now also, really quick, I got ahead of time because I said I was going to do the iPhone X. This is a case from Spigen that I got on Amazon. It's their clear liquid hybrid. It's flexible. I love these cases because not only can you see through it, The back is flexible. It's not like a hard plastic like this one is. And you'll be able to, it'll keep it from, you know, small drops, scratches, but not major, you know, drops. This isn't like an OtterBox. But for those really wanting to see real quick, this is the Plus, and this is the 10 right here. So this is basically what you're going to see in terms of sizes. Now, I don't have, you know, mock-up models like the other pro reviewers do. I have to do well with cases, but that's what you're going to see in as far as size goes for you. So, and remember, it is with the 10 edged edge screen. So a lot of this, except for notch, hashtag notch life, is going to be all screen. So I just wanted to show you that real quick as like a size comparison for something coming up in the future. So this is booted up. Let's see. Another thing I wanted to see what real quick on this video is wireless charging. Let's see. I have it connected to, this is just an inexpensive one I got on Amazon, and I have it connected to a battery pack. Oh, and it's charging. Look at that. I don't know if you heard the sound, but yeah, it is charging. You can see the little green light. It's normally supposed to be blue, but it's green. So you don't have to actually go out and get like a expensive Samsung charger or a Mophie one. Here, we'll do the sound again. There we go. I think I got this one, and I'll leave a link in the description. But I think I got this for like $14.99 on Amazon. It's worked really well. It worked with my S8 when I had that. And I've just kept it around, hoping that one day Apple would do wireless charging so that it can sit upwards instead of laying down flat like most chargers. So that's pretty cool. That works, even when connected to a battery pack. All right. Well, that's really going to be it for me. I'm going to go set this up, play around with it. Make sure to leave a comment down below of any questions you have about, definitely about battery life and camera, because those are the things I'm going to be mainly focusing on. Ooh, everything got bright. Everything got dark. Oh, well. So, yeah, and make sure to hit like if you liked any part of this video. I can understand if you don't, because it's just a real quick one. And also make sure to subscribe so that you'll be able to see my review, which I'm currently working on and almost done for the new Apple Watch, the LTE one, right here. Also for the small review for this and for the unboxing and review for when the iPhone 10 comes out. All right. So thank you very much, guys. And always be excellent to each other. And I'll talk to you guys soon.